Hello everybody, today I want to show you how we close our rivets. For that we have to cut our round material. Here first I put the ring on it, then I take, don't know the English word, you know it. You can take this one, or you can take a metal saw, what you want. So now you have not be so exactly. Let me show you here. The ring is, watch on your eyes, please. Yes, the ring is still there. Here you can see, and now you can use a file and file it down so that you have 1 millimeter material over the ring. Here you can use a file or what you have, and then please clean up your knife. I take spray duster. It's air with pressure. Here, I show you. So, always keep your knife clean. So, I do this already here on this rivet. I hope you can see here. It's a little bit higher, 1 millimeter, then the ring. And now let's do our job. You need a hard ground here. All tools are inside. The corkscrew, when I do this job, it's always open. I don't know why, it's how I do. And now you use your ball hammer here and make the head of your rivet. Here you can see, now it's closed, but it's the question, is there enough pressure to the liners, or maybe it's too much? How we could know? We open the blade and then here there's space. I can put it a little bit to the left and a little bit to the right. Here, I'm not sure if you can see. So, and here, look, the ring, I can rotate the ring. That's not good. We close all tools and make more pressure. Rotating. No longer rotating. It's not perfect. If you do too much pressure to the liners, now it's perfect. Perfect. If you do too much pressure, you did not hear the snap noise. Hear it? That's okay. and so on. You will do it. This is our first rivet. You close. Then this is our second. After that, you close this one. And this one is the last rivet I close in the way I do this job. So I showed you how to close the rivet. Do it at your Swiss Army knife with this and those. And then I will show you in the next video how we can close this rivet. Okay? Bye.